Today we're going to be talking about how to find the arc length of a polar curve. And in this particular problem, we've been given the polar curve r equals sine squared of theta over 2. And we've been asked to find the arc length of that curve on the range theta greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to pi. So the arc length formula we're going to use for a polar curve is L equals the integral from a to b of the square root of r squared, where r represents our original function, our original polar function, plus dr over d theta, or the derivative of our original function, squared. So we'll go ahead and start writing out this integral. A to b is going to be our limits of integration here, 0 and pi, that we've been given. We've got a here equal to 0 and b equal to pi. So we'll say 0 to pi of the square root of r squared. Remember that r is our original function. We should have a function equal to r. If you're given something and it's not equal to r, go ahead and solve it for r if you can. So then we'll get sine squared of theta over 2, and that's going to be squared because we've got this r squared here. So we have squared, and then plus dr over d theta. Dr over d theta represents the derivative of our function r, so we're going to need to go ahead and take that, and let's go ahead and do that right now. So dr over d theta is going to be equal to our function here, sine squared of theta over 2. We can think about it as, and let's just draw this in brackets because it's not actually part of our derivative, it's just kind of an intermediate step. We can think of it as sine of theta over 2 squared, right, where this squared is on the outside. We just move the exponent like this here to the outside. So when we take the derivative, according to power rule, we're going to take the exponent and we're going to move it out in front. So we're going to get 2. This is going to be an exercise here in chain rule. So 2 times sine of theta over 2, we're going to leave the inside untouched. And then according to power rule, 2 minus 1 gives us 1. So that's raised to the first power, and we don't actually need to write that because it's redundant. So we'll just go ahead and leave that. But according to chain rule, now we have to multiply by the derivative of sine of theta over 2. We can't just leave that inside alone. We've got to multiply by the derivative. So the derivative of sine of theta over 2 is cosine of theta over 2, because the derivative of sine is cosine. And then, again, according to chain rule, we need to multiply by the derivative of theta over 2 because we can't leave that alone either. Well, the derivative of theta over 2 is simply 1/2. So now we can go ahead and simplify this. Our 2's here, the one out in front and the one at the end, are going to cancel. So we're just going to be left with sine of theta over 2 times cosine of theta over 2. That's our derivative. That's dr over d theta. So going back to our formula, we'll get sine of theta over 2 times cosine of theta over 2. And of course, according to our formula here, we have to square this. So we'll square it. We'll close off our square root symbol. And then we need d theta out here at the end. Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and distribute our exponents here. We're going to apply this power of 2 to both of our terms here. So 0 to pi times the square root. Sine squared of theta over 2 is going to give us sine to the fourth of theta over 2. And then when we square our second term, instead of sine theta over 2 times cosine theta over 2, we'll get sine squared theta over 2 times cosine squared of theta over 2. It's cosine squared theta over 2. Okay, and then we'll close off our square root sign, and we've got d theta. Now, notice that we can factor out from this underneath the square root bracket. We can factor out a sine squared theta over 2. So we'll get 0 to pi of the integral of sine squared times theta over 2 multiplied by sine squared theta over 2, right? We have to multiply these two together in order to get sine to the fourth theta over 2. But then we'll add this sine squared theta over 2 is going to come out, so we're just left with cosine squared of theta over 2. And then we'll put the d theta. So this is going to happen a lot when you're finding arc length of a polar curve. You'll very often be able to get to a point where you have sine squared of the variable or theta over 2 or something like that plus cosine squared. Remember that this is going to be equal to 1. Remember that trigonometric identity that tells us that sine squared of, we'll just call it theta, plus cosine squared of theta is going to be equal to 1. Well, it doesn't matter what theta is, whether it's 2 theta, theta, theta over 2, it does whatever it is, it's going to be equal to 1. So this whole part here is going to go away because that's going to be equal to 1. And we're just left with the square root of sine squared theta over 2. Well, the square root of something squared, right, that just goes away. So we're left with the integral from 0 to pi of simply sine of theta over 2 d theta. So now we don't have to simplify this anymore. We can just go ahead and take the integral. So L is going to be, remember that the integral of sine is negative cosine. So we'll end up with negative cosine of theta over 2. But because we have theta over 2 in here, chain rule tells us that we now have to go and divide by the derivative of theta over 2. Well, the derivative of theta over 2 is 1/2. So we need to divide by 1/2. Remember that dividing by 1/2 is the same as multiplying by 2. So this negative cosine here is going to turn into negative 2 cosine theta over 2. And we'll be evaluating that on the range 0 to pi. So now we just need to plug in our limits of integration. So we'll get L equals negative 2 cosine of pi over 2 minus a negative 2, so that's going to give us a plus 2 cosine of 0 over 2, which is just going to be 0. Cosine of pi over 2 is going to be equal to 0, so this whole term here, 0 times negative 2, is still 0, so that's going to go away. Cosine of 0 we know to be equal to 1, so we'll get 2 times 1, which of course gives us 2, and that is our final answer. So the arc length of this polar curve, r equals sine squared of theta over 2, on the range 0 to pi is 2. So that's it. That's our final answer. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.